This is how to get molar mass from osmotic pressure. BSA, or bovine serum albumin, is a common protein concentration standard. A 2.43 gram sample of BSA is dissolved in enough water to make 10.00 mL of solution. The osmotic pressure of the solution is found to be 0.0879 atmospheres. What is the molar mass of BSA? Okay. Well, molar mass, you may recall, is equal to grams per mole. So, we know how many grams we have, 2.43 grams. If only we knew how many moles we had, we could answer this question. Now, this involves osmotic pressure, so as you can imagine, we need to use the formula. Osmotic pressure is equal to IRTM. All right, we're actually given the pressure, and R is always a constant in the temperature, so it may occur to you that, we can either be solving for I or capital M. Well, proteins only have a van't Hoff factor of 1, so we're actually going to solve for molarity. So I'm going to rearrange this equation to say that the molarity is equal to the osmotic pressure divided by I times R times T. Okay, now just time to substitute in our variables. The osmotic pressure is given to us, 0.0879 atmospheres. The van't Hoff factor, as I mentioned, is 1. R is 0.0821 liter atmosphere per Kelvin mole. And our temperature, we should probably put in Kelvin, so it will cancel out. I think I forgot to include the temperature in this question. We will say the temperature is 20 degrees Celsius, because a lot of times you work with proteins that you cool, so they won't denature on you. So we will get this into Kelvin, and it is 273.15 plus 20 to give us degrees Kelvin. Okay, when you punch that into your calculator, you will discover that the value that comes out is 3.652 times 10 to the minus 3. And the units, well, atmospheres cancel out, Kelvins cancel out. And we have liters on the bottom, and 1 over 1 over a mole gives us moles on top. So that's units of molarity, that's useful, that's moles per liter. Okay, if we have, you may remember this formula from before, if we have a volume and a concentration, we can get ourselves some moles. So our volume is 10 mils, right? Where is that? Right up there. And I'm going to write that in liters, 0.01 liters. Our concentration we just figured out as 3.652 times 10 to the minus 3. Mole per liter. So it turns out that we have 3.652 times 10 to the minus 5 moles. Okay, this is the value that we needed right up here. Okay, so I will take 2.43 grams and divide it by 3.652 times 10 to the minus 5 moles, punch that into my calculator, and it turns out that 66535 comes out. Or, if we write it in appropriate sig figs, 6.65 times 10 to the 4th grams per mole. That's how you do it.